I've got only 3 more days before my midterm tests. I feel like this is the time I get the most DMs, mostly for advice. Stuff like, hey Jonna, what are the best study methods? Jonna, how many hours should I be studying? How do I get started, Jonna? This is hard. You know what? I think it's time for my study break anyway. So let's get to the bottom of these and other study questions. This is Kayan Explains the Secrets to Study. The brain can be a little mysterious. How exactly does it do what it does? I spoke to an expert in neuroscience to help me understand a few basic concepts. Everything that we think, do, feel, and the memories we create are because of our brain. It has 171 billion cells in it. That's more than there are seconds in 5,000 years. The brain is a spongy storage machine. It files everything we learn first in a place called the hippocampus, then in another place called the neocortex. Among those 171 billion cells, there are pathways that go to and from the neocortex. When we study, we strengthen those pathways, making it easier for us to retrieve those memories. It's the repetition and practice done while studying that makes those connections in our brain stronger. There can be a lot of challenges when studying, like distractions. Hey Jonna, how many hours should I be studying? How do I study smarter, not harder? Jonna, is there an app for this? Distractions can come from any and everywhere. Oh, my favorite YouTuber just posted, and another streamer just went live. The best thing to do is to make study time distraction-free. And a lot of times, that just means turning stuff off. And you know what? Once you've done that, there might be more hurdles to overcome. Like procrastination. That's when you delay an important task, even if you know there are going to be consequences. Then there's multitasking. That's trying to do more than one thing at the same time. Splitting your focus can make it really hard to study. Some people think it's a flex to do many things at once. Spoiler, nah, not at all. Time management is deciding the amount of time you should commit to doing something and sticking to it. Poor time management can lead to cramming, trying to cram as much information into your brain as fast as possible to be ready for that upcoming test. All of these things can lead to burnout. It's like your brain crashing into a wall, leaving you physically and mentally drained. Challenges can be overwhelming. People have been using study methods for a long time, and some of them are old, like memorization, highlighting, using flashcards. Some study methods that are current and trendy have also been around for a while, like blurting. That's when you write down all the information you can remember about a topic and then go back to your notes and fill in everything you've missed or gotten wrong. Active recall. This one is my favorite. Instead of rereading my notes, I make practice questions and quiz myself. Mind mapping is a visual way to organize information around a central topic. This one is really popular and it can be really fun. Then there's Studytok. It's a community of influencers and users on TikTok who share study techniques and tools. Tools? Yes, there are a lot of digital tools. Some are simple, like the timer that you see on this video. Others are AI powered. They can summarize and create quizzes tailored to what you are studying. These are helpful for active recall, but you need to be careful. There is still a lot of debate on how reliable AI can be as a study partner. It's easy to fall in love with Studytok, but watch out for those sponsored ads. Brand experts, influencers, and apps might promise you the keys to studying. This app got me into the university. This is how you get 100% on your next test with this hack. Buyer beware. Be critical about what you see and hear. No single app or hack will give you great grades. But there is one surprising and simple truth to successful studying. Sleep. The expert we spoke to told us that sleep is an important part of how your brain strengthens the memories you've made while awake. So make sure you're getting enough of it. Studying doesn't have to be scary or intimidating. It doesn't have to be boring or hard. There's no one thing that will make you a better student, but patience helps. Hopefully, understanding a little of the science and a few good study behaviors can make you more confident in that test that is only 3 days away. I better go. Please wish me luck. For CBC Kids News, I'm Jonnakae Hoskins.